How can we manage our Ware flows between our stations and X4 foundations? Today I introduce you to sector activities and trade restrictions, which can easily replace repeat orders and clean up our unassigned ship tab. When we click on a station, we find in the instructions tab the option to give blacklists for the subordinates. Our options are sector travel, which restricts the sectors to which they are allowed to travel, trade restrictions. This restricts the factions with which they are allowed to trade, and sector activities. Here we tell them in which sectors they are allowed to trade or mine. This especially helps with miners that are always wasting time by running 5 sectors away just to mine there. To develop an understanding of these rules, we quickly set up 2 blacklists and apply them to our test scenario. In the first rule, we will restrict sector activities in all systems, except the system in which our receiver station lies. The second will be a trade restriction. Here we simply restrict all factions except us. This rule is optional because it can be replaced with the trade rule that restricts all factions but us. But using the trade restrictions is softer and keeps the option open to allow other factions to buy from our station directly. Now I apply these rules to the trade hub. The other 2 stations are only allowed to trade within the system and produce goods for the hub. According to that scenario, I would expect that our hub will sell the goods to our trade hub in Fares of Defeat, which certainly buys the right wares, while the 2 production facilities will sell their goods with their own trader to the hub. But what will we see in addition is that the hub also buys with his own chips from the production facilities. So it seems the station's home system is always allowed on the sector activity restrictions. This leads us to our first use. We can set up a hub that distributes all VS between our station and the system. By using auto pricing in our stations, the distribution center will fill shortages automatically and pay up VS that are stocked up. The system helps to keep an overview over your production chains when your station count grows, because we can identify problems quickly by looking at the shortages and surpluses. Also, it helps to track the trader count and makes it easier to optimize the utilization, because we don't need trader for every single station if the Ware flow is managed by only one. Also, we can use a pull-push effect with our trade hub that pulls all produced wares in the system together and pushes them into another one. At last, I want to talk how we can use this to replace repeat orders. Let's say we have a scenario where we have a whole part factory in one system, and we want to sell the products to the wharf 10 jumps or more away. The solution is to build a chain of stations that can only trade in one way. For this, we build a midway station and restrict the sector activities of the whole part factory to the midway system. At the same time, the trade fleet of the midway station is restricted to trade only in the wharf system or with another system along the way. I can imagine that there are many more uses for sector activities, and I hope you can apply this rule in your game to solve logistical problems. Until next time.